Each time a man stands up for an ideal, or acts to improve the lot of others, or strikes out against injustice, he sends forth a tiny ripple of hope, and crossing each other from a million different centers of energy and daring, those ripples build a current which can sweep down the mightiest walls of oppression and resistance.
In Harry Potter's world, the Phoenix is a real and symbolic presence. Its ability to rise from the ashes reinforces the story's underlying theme of renewal and resurrection. The Song of the Phoenix inspires fear or courage, depending upon a person's character. Even its tears have healing power. For our next winner, this mythic bird so powerfully embodies his way of looking at the world that he's assumed its name as his own. Lou Perkins, better known as Phoenix, of Hurricane, West Virginia, is most definitely a force of nature. His art and his advocacy are helping to change the way communities view people with disabilities. Phoenix dismisses praise. He prefers to keep the spotlight on the couple he has faithfully served as a direct support professional for nearly 5 years, especially a man named Delmar. Despite his multiple diagnoses, Delmar has taken on the advocacy role his wife, Karen, gave up because of her own progressive disability. He fights budget cuts at the state capitol, serves on various People First committees, and attends the organization's national conference in Washington. Delmar recently received the People First Lifetime Achievement Award, but none of it was possible without Phoenix. "I call myself the parrot," he laughed. Phoenix serves as facilitator, coach, and one-man cheering section. He is also Delmar's translator because his voice is often unintelligible to those who don't know him well. They both recently appeared on the front page of the state's leading newspaper, Delmar speaking and Phoenix translating during a Medicare rally. "I was a nervous wreck when they first handed me the microphone," Phoenix recalled. "But I don't think of what I do as extraordinary. I consider it an extraordinary experience." Phoenix also makes it possible for Delmar to pursue his other interests, namely art and family. These 21st century adventurers are often found hitting the open road in pursuit of excitement and a family connection. Phoenix ensures Delmar sees his three cousins. Perhaps that's because the two of them have become like family. "We adopted each other right away," said Phoenix. "I liked you the first time I met you," Delmar told him. Their mutual love for art connected them. "I've always been an artist," explained Phoenix, who brings together paint and other media to create what he calls post-modern conglomerations. He enjoys pottery, sculpture, and papier-mâché. He takes on commissions, he shows in galleries, and he teaches a painting class at REM Community Options Day Program every week. "Phoenix is a very big in our art community," said Jamie Castro, REM program director and Phoenix's nominator. "He and Delmar share this passion on a daily basis. They work on different art projects together and bounce ideas and creativity back and forth. This bond is so strong that Phoenix turned down a promotion that would have taken him away from supporting Delmar. "I'm here for a reason," explained Phoenix. "Delmar needs stability, he needs support. It feels wrong to leave him now. And sometimes you just have to do what your heart tells you." Vincent van Gogh would agree. He said, "There's nothing more truly artistic than to love people." Phoenix, for understanding that the art in humanity and the humanity in art, for living the life of a true artist through your brush and through your heart, and for empowering others through dedication, compassion, and with your own voice, I am proud to present you with the Ripple of Hope Award.